The Youth Winter Olympic Games have brought me over to Lillehammer in Norway. It's still early in the season here, so they are making snow, because getting these slopes to competition standard isn't easy.
Here in Highfield we have about 250 snow guns. They're all controlled from a big control room, and they all are connected together. It's a lot about planning, like to put the guns at the right place. It's about wind. If you put it on the wrong side, it's going to be a lot of snow in the trees. That's why we have two teams working night and day, the whole fall, the whole winter, to make sure everything is perfect.
Here in the snow gun, huge amounts of water and air are being forced through tiny nozzles, creating a fine mist that freezes into fresh powder. But while the weather is cold, the temperature is actually not quite below freezing here. So why does this water freeze into snow? Why doesn't it just rain? Okay, physics. As water evaporates, it sucks heat from the surrounding environment. Put some water on your hand and blow on it, and the wet part will feel colder because that evaporating water is sucking the heat away from your body. That's what's going on here. Some of these water droplets evaporate, so they drop the temperature around them, which means other droplets might start to freeze. And once that's started, you get what are called nucleation sites, the start of snowflakes. And if it's not quite working efficiently enough, then you can buy a kind of protein slurry. You add it, very diluted, to the water, and suddenly every droplet is a nucleation site and can form its own snowflake.
To make snow, we have pipes for water and pipes for air. On top of that, every cannon needs like a computer cable. The water here in Highfjell comes from big lakes at the top of the mountain. And from there, it's a natural pressure going down. That's the easiest and less expensive way. During a normal season, we use about 30,000 liters a minute. It sounds a lot, but we have a big, big lake. So during the whole season, it's about 5 to 10 centimeters down. And that's if nothing, no new water is coming in. So most of the time, it just looks like it's not touched.
The drier the air is, the more water can evaporate into it. So if the air is really, really dry, 0% humidity, you can make proper snow when the air temperature is well above freezing, anything up to 6 degrees Celsius. But if the air is humid, there is nowhere for those droplets to evaporate to. At 100% humidity, when the air is saturated, the temperature has to be -2 or lower to make snow, because this isn't some kind of instant magic freezer. The laws of thermodynamics pretty much make that impossible. Much as it'd be great to have a snow gun that works in the middle of summer, all you're going to end up with then is a rainmaker.
So snowmaking is really important for big contests, but it's also really important for just the average day here in Highfjell with normal people. It's what we need to make this mountain work. Without, we would be nothing. We need snow.
There's a load more videos over on the Olympics channel and on my channel. Go check them out, go subscribe, and thank you to the Youth Winter Olympic Games for bringing me out here to Lillehammer.